And you know, they got it set up in one of the great big old theaters in there, the Opera House, and man, it's beautiful in there.
What you want? No.
But it's huge. I mean, the thing seats like 1,000 people, and it's been full every show we've been doing down there. It makes us feel all good. But the lighting, when they put the spotlights on us, we can't see the people in the audience. We know they're there because we can hear them. And today, we was doing this show, earlier this morning, our first show, and I could tell that there was a group of young women over on this side, and they was just squealing and hollering when I'd take a break on the mandolin, and boy, I mean, they sounded like they looked good. And like I said, we got Audrey's married. I am married. I don't mean I sounded like they looked good to me. But anyway, so I'm looking, you know, I can't see anybody. But I'm a showman in this business, and I kind of think, you know, if I can hear them, if they're over there on that way, I'm going to kind of look that way. Send out one of them little winks. And I did. And after that show, we was out at the CD table, and this guy by the name of John followed me around the rest of the day. And then, like, well, everything was fine until he gave him my cell phone number.
Well, he seemed like a nice fella.
We're gonna do a song here that we close all of our shows with. And this is a fiddle tune. I know you've heard this many times before, and that's why we try to do it differently each and every time that we do it, because we don't want this song to become repetitive and redundant.
That's not a word.
Well, what that word means, redundant, that means we're not gonna do it the same way we did it today. We're gonna do it a little bit different so it's still fresh. It won't be redundant.
What?
I know that we're going to do it. Yes, we're going to do it.
Well, how do you do
it? Ladies and gentlemen, this is the nothing fancy version of the Orange Blossom Special.
Thank you.
Mr. King, come on now.
Oh, you folks ever seen the Green Acres program? That was his favorite program as a child, and every once in a while I got to remind him of that, so getting back into bluegrass music. Now, what you need to do, Chris, is take the bowl and pour it in.